In 24 hours, Britain's newest radio station, 106 FM, starts broadcasting to the East Midlands.
FM. We're all right now.
Chapter, and it goes back to the first chapter, because 30 years ago, almost to the day, Ron Coles and I were involved in this country's first local radio station, and this is now, for me, I think the last one. It's hey, one more time, and it means a lot to me. It's terribly exciting, a bit scary. There's a saying in the East Midlands about bricking it, and over the last few months and weeks, the frequency of bricking it has become higher and higher, but along with the fear and the apprehension and all the rest of it, there's a real buzz, a real adrenaline flowing.
It's going all right, really. It's going all right. We've rehearsed the show about 12 times, I would say. Perhaps this is the unlucky 13th, but we've rehearsed the show that many times. We haven't yet got it perfect all the way through, which is obviously very troubling because we do need to get it right tomorrow.
While rehearsals continue for tomorrow's big launch, the boss has more mundane things to worry about.
I think most things are well under control, but a couple of things that have, I found out as I've got in this morning. I asked one of the guys to touch up some dirty marks on the wall, but unfortunately when the paint was touched up, it looks different. So we've got some nice blotches. Can't start doing that until lunchtime because the reception desk hasn't arrived yet. And we are expecting it at about 10:30 this morning, and I'm told the guys will have it fitted by 12:30.
I genuinely believe in radio advertising as an effective way to either brand a product or get a message across, and I consider that to be fundamental.
The 9 o'clock news for 106 FM, this is Pip Watts.
Today we're going to see a guy called Jim Mersch at Creative Interiors. He runs a kitchen and bathroom sort of design and planning company.
I've made loads of mistakes in the past. For example, the couple that cracked open a bottle of champagne on their wedding night, which was terrible. The transfer of Alan Shearer for £1.50.
And basically look pretty and smart and clever.
The last management meeting before the launch, and top of the agenda, the clocks are wrong.
I believe the clock on the wall is now right, but I don't know whether the computer clock is.
No, the computer clock won't be, because it's not linked to rugby, is it?
Well, the computer clocks aren't being sent the correct time. In fact, they're a minute out.
Are adjusting themselves as they're supposed to.
I mean, they should always be correct.
There's two in the newsroom. One is right and one is wrong. One is a minute behind, because it can't get a signal where it is.
We need to review that, because if that computer clock is out, then we've got real problems.
10:30 and reception finally arrives.
It's easier to carry it like this.
12:30. Clive is going to repaint reception.
Well, the whole reception.
Well, I think we're going to have to do big chunks. Yeah. It's the only way it's going to make.
Because our security panel is
that
it's completely
be
different colour.
Because they're coming this afternoon to put the board up on that wall as well, remember, for Simons.
This is true, yeah.
Well, yeah.
It'll take, I'm told it takes about a couple of hours to dry. So, I think we just go with that.
But management plans will have to wait. Redecorating can't begin until reception is built, and that's some way off. And management aren't the only ones with some juggling to do.
It's good to look different from salespeople. Salespeople always wear suits. I'm involved in doing the commercials, so whatever a client needs to advertise, I'm responsible for putting together his commercial, making it sound as interesting as possible.
Planning permission for the official station sign hasn't arrived yet, so for now, they're making do.
Stevie baby. Ready when you are, Creative Interiors.
Yes.
Martin used to be the singer in a pop group. Now he hopes his performance skills will land him and Steve the big sales deal.
Swinging, we'll do it the usual way. I'll do the presentation, you do the fact find when I've finished.
Okay.
And let's do it.
Reception still isn't ready.
106 FM has six journalists, and with those we have to cover three counties, Nottinghamshire, Leicestershire and Derbyshire, so it's quite a tall order. The big story on the first day that we open will obviously be us. We'd like to be able to lead saying the East Midlands' newest regional radio station 106 FM has opened, etc, etc. But if we have another rail crash such as the one we had at Southall in Middlesex last Friday, it would sound a bit incongruous to lead on ourselves. So let's keep our fingers crossed that most of the news is fairly peripheral and we can lead on ourselves.
So while the news editor hopes for no news, Clive the security guard has become Clive the painter and decorator.
You seem to be off air, guys.
Meanwhile, DJ Dickie Dodd has phoned from home in something of a panic. He thinks the station's test transmissions have stopped.
Are we still here?
Yeah, still on air.
We're only using pre-fade.
Dickie rang from home. We're radiating nothing. We haven't touched anything, have we?
Well,
I've just hit start again, and
we're
using pre-fade just to you to,
yeah,
no, that's to okay. do that. That's all we're doing.
Well, we are on air. Well, I just when everybody was panicking upstairs, I pressed the button. My radio came up. We were on air. So what we must have lost is pre-fade.
Well, Dickie was listening at home and said we're off.
We were setting up the voice cards. The only thing we used was the pre-fade.
That shouldn't.
So we haven't. That shouldn't
affect it. So we're definitely on in my room.
Okay. Yeah. Right.
Plus this is radio.
Yeah. Panic over.
Get Nicky a new radio for tomorrow.
Yeah.
It's 12 o'clock, and in Derby, Martin and Steve arrive for the big sell.
So what is Radio 106 FM? We are a music and talk radio station for Leicestershire, Derbyshire, and Nottinghamshire. It's a cross-county regional superstation. It's mainly big name stars, Elton John, Dire Straits, Tina Turner, Bruce Springsteen. It's sort of toe-tapping, familiar music. Who's involved? Ron Coles is an inspiration to work for. What he doesn't know about radio isn't worth knowing, to be honest.
But Ron and Ken, selecting the music playlist, struggle to recognise this Stones hit.
Well, if we're sitting here debating a track that none of us...
Right.
Yeah, it's all right.
Well, let's see what it... Well, we will when it comes up. Well, I knew it, and, you know. Let's get the vocal.
No.
It's not familiar.
It's too raw. It's not familiar.
Familiar to me.
And he keeps bees.
Right.
So that's the personal interest.
There's a relevancy there.
Yeah, he is actually a very major beekeeper. He's something like the chairman of all beekeepers in the UK or something. He's a very important beekeeping guy.
What about?
So will the very important beekeeping guy prefer the beautiful South?
I mean, there's some good ones which would be spot on, but again, if we're trying to get something that's relatively up to date. Yeah. I'll buy that.
He knows who his market is and he knows what he wants.
Yeah.
So, I've got a fairly good idea of how to pitch it.
I think because he's one of those clients that knows so much about radio and he's used it to good effect before, we're going to have to make this work. We're going to have to get the creative's got to be right. Not that it won't be, because I'm sure it will. But I'm very confident, to be honest.
They're 50-second adverts.
Back at Radio 106 FM, the senior advertising sales executive, Vicky Clark, is also trying to win clients. And that competition is strong among the sales team to land the first big deal.
Right, okay.
Reception and painting, still not finished.
Okay, cheers.
Right, this is the heart of the radio section. This is where all the vital equipment sits. Most vital of all are these computers down here. These hold all the music, all the records, all the jingles, all the adverts. If this falls over, we're stuck, in a word, and it's me that has to keep it running.
Well done everybody, we're well on schedule, 16 hours to go, and I think we've got most of it all battened down. If we haven't, you'll tell me in just a moment or two, I'm sure. But I just want to say how much I appreciate everything that's gone on. It's been a team effort, you've all played your part. And I'm really pleased with what we've done so far. Of course, it'll all be down to what it sounds like when we go on air tomorrow morning. But so far, so good.
They call me Tim will fix it because I spend most of my time going around doing odd jobs and this and that, as well as the wiring and the technical side of it.
We had a bit of a cock-up on the painting front over the weekend, So Clive the security man has turned into Clive the painter. And
yes, but just who made that cock-up in the first place?
At the weekend I went to a paint supplier. The decorators had given me a colour to get. Once I got the colour and painted a few patches on the walls in reception, when it dried it didn't prove to be the right colour. But I'd gone home before it dried. So this morning I came in and there were these sort of blotches. So I had to get the security guard to repaint it.
And a glass of champagne in here for everybody tomorrow at 5:45.
While all that's going on, reporter Liz Curtis is on the trail of a hot news story, and she's taken a new digital recorder with her.
It's a very modern piece of equipment.
Yep, it's the snazziest piece of equipment we've had for a long time.
Yeah.
Press all the right buttons. Okay, and that's rolling now. Okay, first of all, lose my headphones. You could say your name and your title here.
Yes, Linda Love, Media Relations Manager, East Midlands Airport.
Okay, the levels are great.
We're all computerised. It's very different for people who've been working in analogue radio studios to come to computerised studios. So a lot of it's been getting used to the mechanics, getting used to the computers.
To also fight for their right for duty-free shopping, which is part of the holiday experience for a lot of people.
Okay, thanks. I'll just check that's there.
The launch party is almost at the back of my mind. The really focused part of my mind is 6 o'clock tomorrow morning when the radio station goes on air. I mean, this is important. It's a sort of culmination. It's saying thank you to all the people who have helped us over the months to get the license, all the people who have supported us in building the radio station, putting together the bits and pieces. But the real focus is tomorrow morning, 6 o'clock, when we go on air.
Hopefully with Liz's interview.
Yep, that's there.
We've got two telephone balancing units which allow us to...
But back in the computer room, things are about to go wrong.
Sorry to interrupt. Drastic emergency in the news booth. Can you come and help me out with the ITM line? Thank you very much. Sorry.
Steve needs the high-tech ISDN telephone line to make his adverts. It isn't working, and that's a major problem.
Can you hear anything back from him?
No, nothing at all.
And he can't hear anything from you?
No.
I think it must be settings in the central machine, so we'll have to go there and fiddle.
Right.
Hello, this is Gary Lineker. You're listening to Dickie Dodd on Radio 106 FM.
Working with computers at this station, well, basically I try to avoid computers as much as I can. Pen and pad I'm a lot happier with at home. It's not been really too easy for me coming to Radio 106 FM. The station I worked at before, it was not quite as technical as it is here. Everything downstairs, as you've probably seen, is operated from a computer. So it's been a case of kicking, dragged, screamed into the 21st century, learning all the computery bits over the last 6 weeks in the run-up to the launch tomorrow.
Okay, and have you got a message for the people of Radio 106 FM?
Not particularly.
Hey, Alison, this looks better.
Reception and the new paint job are finally finished. Ron's a happy man. But Steve isn't. He has to tell his boss that Tim hasn't fixed it.
And who? How many ads are we talking about that need to be made?
Six.
So we need six ads made?
Mm-hmm.
Within the next couple of hours?
Yes.
Watching the news, I've often wondered to myself just what the heck George Bush made of Dan Quayle.
In the studio, rehearsals continue, but the celebrity launch party is next.
What he really, really thought of him, but it wasn't quite as polite as we're led to believe officially.
No, probably not, but...
Ibiza 82, Miami 86, and Athens bathing in a whopping 91 degrees Fahrenheit. Oh, to be in Athens today.
Welcome. About an hour to go. Time for a quick shave.
We will find you acting on your best behavior. Turn your back on the world.
6 o'clock news for 106 FM. This is Pip Watts. The headlines this hour.
The champagne's iced and the party is nearly underway. But Tim's still not fixed it. And the fizz has gone out of life for Martin, the sales executive.
Great start. Creative Interiors was really good, as you'll see. But this afternoon sort of tailed off quite rapidly.
But it's been a much better day for his colleague, Vicky.
Okay, we'll do that right now. Okay, so we're on. So we're on. Lovely. Thank you, Katie. Thanks a lot. Bye. We did it!
Client I was hoping would come through. Is not. I've not managed to secure an appointment.
Under that.
Okay.
Off you go. Get it done. Get it faxed. Let's get the order.
Vicky Clark has landed Radio 106 FM's first big advertising deal.
That sales. Tomorrow's another day. Hopefully it'll be better in the morning.
No, you're not driving.
No.
Are you driving?
Here we go.
Oh. Thank you.
Thanks for coming.
The celebrities, John Savident and Sherry Hewson, Coronation Street's Fred and Maureen, arrive.
It's the wedding. Yes,
yeah,
it's the wedding.
That is the wedding. Oh, gosh.
Tonight.
Yes, yeah, isn't it?
Tonight. 7:30.
Tonight.
We're married.
We're married.
We're
that
married.
Looks as if you've already been having a bit
of... No, but I'm hoping that I shall be having more later. <Yeah. laughs> So, happy to pay for that.
Yes,
yeah,
of course. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Happy opening.
Cheers.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Happy opening.
Yes.
Then they're all herded outside for the big moment.
I declare it open, I declare it open.
One, two, three, it's open. Yay!
They get married on Coronation Street tonight, and in fact, if everything fits in properly and nobody's paid more money to push us out, our first advert, the launch of our advertising campaign on Central TV, is the advert before the show. Please enjoy the evening, meet Sherry and John, have a look round, tune in tomorrow, 6 o'clock sharp!
Radio 106 FM, radio for grown-ups.
The party's in full swing, but Ron's with the big boss from Border Television.
I think tonight's gone really well. If the programming goes as well tomorrow morning, which is at the end of the day what really matters, then I shall be extremely pleased. But really, Peter's the man who's having to answer to the board for all the money, so you better see what Peter thinks.
Well, it's been an awful lot of money. But if we have to judge the station's success by tonight, and just looking at the people out there enjoying themselves, I think we're in for a really good time over the next couple of years.
It's getting late. And breakfast presenter Dickie Dodd is worried he'll forget something. So a little routine is developed, ending with the setting of the clocks.
I've got two clocks, and one on my watch as well there, that they're all set and turned on. Because if I don't do all that, I'm just going to worry far too much to ever get to sleep.
Back at the studios, the commercial feed line never did get fixed, so Steve still hasn't made tomorrow's adverts.
I think I'm the only one left here. I'll probably be getting out of here at about midnight tonight, which is all down to those pesky ISDN lines going down. If we hadn't had a problem with them, then I could have recorded voiceovers today. As it was, I've had to have a tape send down from Hull. So I just need to stitch them together, and then I can go too.
Steve burns the midnight oil to meet the launch deadline in just a few hours' time. Finally, it's the big day.
I've had better night's sleep.
You're right. Seems, you know, we've done this blooming thing about 20 times.
Yeah.
We must be able to. Must be able to do it again once.
Yeah. Just the once.
I know. But all the times we did it, we never got it right.
No one ever did fix the clocks.
Stand by. The East Midlands' newest radio station launches this morning. Be listening at 6 a.m. for the start of Radio 106 FM.
Good boy. Good boy.
I had a look at the national prospects. There's a couple of bits and pieces about the Ulster Unionists. There's something about the Liberal Democrats conference, but I think Radio 106 FM is going to be the lead story this morning.
Radio 106 FM, Radio 106 FM. It's 6 a.m. on Tuesday, the 23rd of September, 1997. And now, it's for real!
News, news, music and more. Radio 106 FM.
Good morning, I'm Dickie Dodd, your regular breakfast.
8 months later, Radio 106 FM has already been put out to pasture. The corporate money men at Border Television have decided it's already time for a change. So now it's Century 106, the same name as Border Television's other radio stations. It's called branding, and it's done to please not the listeners, but the advertisers. A new look, a new advertising campaign, and a new breakfast show host, Dickie Dodd, has decided to call it a day.
Excellent.
It seemed to me that I was being a little bit, having to be a bit more contained than I really like. Because I like being on the radio, because I like being on. So I had to ponder about it for a while, and I thought that perhaps I'd be better off going back to the kind of show which I was doing before, which was all speech, where I do get to be on a lot.
So out goes Dickie Dodd, and out goes everything to do with Radio 106 FM. Jingles, stationery, even the livery on the sales executives' cars. The cost of this new look, a cool £50,000. But is it really sensible to drop Radio 106 FM after such a short time?
There's never a good time to do something like changing a name, but it made absolute marketing sense, and from a revenue point of view it makes sense. Therefore we have to do it, and therefore the sooner you do it the better. And that's what we've decided to do.
With more news for the East Midlands, this is Andy Hitchcock in the Century 106 News Centre. It's 2:05.
The changes are everywhere and have been done so that the radio station can sell advertising more easily.
Century in the northeast is the most successful regional radio station at the moment. We can benefit from being associated with that brand, and it enables national advertisers to buy all three radio stations at one stop. So it's all to do with moving forward, Progressive Radio Group, simply enough.
That's the sales talk, but Radio 106 has had a turbulent start, and it's far too early to tell whether the renamed Century 106 really will be. Let me tell you.